think they're allowing Tonya to fix her skate, but they're asking Josée Chouinard to come to the ice. I'm sure Josée's not even prepared. This is a difficult call because it's really not fair to Josée. She was expecting to skate after Tonya Harding. And while the previous skater is on, a skater collects their thoughts and gets mentally prepared, and this could throw Josée way off.
That's the USA team leader, Gail Tanger. And now, the Canadian champion, Josée Chouinard, who never dreamed that she would be a part of this improbable story. And yet she has been affected by it.
She has to compose herself as well. I'm sure she's unhappy with this. Again, you psych yourself up during the previous skater's performance. I'm sure she's not ready to perform either. It's going to take everything she's got to get in the right frame of mind.
Josée Chouinard will be given a chance to warm up, her Canadian teammates looking on. When we return, Josée Chouinard on the ice. The boot is not yet laced, and Tonya Harding is battling asthma.
Did you have your nebulizer?
And on the ice, unexpectedly at this point, the Canadian champion, trying gamely to smile and compose herself, Josée Chouinard, skating to an American in Paris.
Josée has so many wonderful qualities. Choreography is very strong. Good jumping ability. She has been inconsistent in the past. Opening jump is a triple flip. She was way off axis in the air, a tilt. She couldn't save the landing. I'm sure she was severely affected by what happened with Tonya Harding. Needs to recover here, triple lutz and a double toe. Triple lutz. Nice recovery. Triple toe loop. Stronger. half triple here, a triple Lutz. She doubles it. Triple, a triple toe loop, and she just didn't get the rotation she needed to land the jump.
This still astonished crowd rewards her well, but Josée Chouinard a bit perplexed by it all. And a somber group of teammates from Canada. Meanwhile, back in the hallway, Tonya Harding does not have her boots on.
From what I understood of the announcement, they're going to let her skate last in this flight. And that's a preferable draw.
Well, you have to think of different things. You did some.
Look at the last combination of jumps here. Split jump, flip. Now she'll turn forwards into a triple toe loop. And on the way down, you'll see that she was about a quarter turn short of the rotation. There's one, two, almost made it. You're extremely tired at the end of the routine. Tough break all the way around for Josée Chouinard. It's so important that you get the mental preparation from the skater before you in order to be in the right frame of mind when you get on the ice. Tough break.
Now the first set of marks, these for technical merit from the nine judges.
Mistakes really cost her. Triple out to the beginning. Fall on triple flip and triple toe loop. I'm sure she would have liked to have just gone ahead normally and not having been rushed to the ice. It almost seems unfair.
And the marks for artistic impression.
The program is beautifully choreographed. She's a charming skater. I'm sure she was hoping for a lot more.
Makes you kind of wish the nine judges had given her some compassion. We'll be right back.
Tomorrow.
The extraordinary chapter in the ongoing saga continues. Backstage, Tonya Harding, who has now been given a reskate, should be the last to skate in this group. Josée Chouinard is with Tracy Wilson.
When you were getting ready backstage, were you aware of what was happening on the ice tonight?
With Tonya, you mean? No, actually, I didn't see her skating, so all of a sudden I watched on the TV just to see where she was about in her program, and I saw she was outside the ice, so I figured she must have fell, or her laces was undone, or I don't know, something must have happened. So I didn't know if she was going back on the ice or not, but I just started to walk towards the ice, and then all of a sudden they said, whenever you're ready, you can go. I was, what? So I stepped on the ice, and Lewis made it sure that I wasn't rushing, and I was walking to the ice. But then at the beginning of the program, I was still rushing a little bit, even though I was holding everything back. And then I got everything set, and I was more calm going into the second jump. It just, I wish I would have done that first, like I really needed it. So I guess I felt a little rushed.
Okay.
This is back in the hallway outside the dressing area, and Tonya Harding, having been granted the privilege of skating last in this group by the referee Britta Lindgren, pacing and talking with her coach Diane Rawlinson. And on the ice, the Japanese champion,